So we have a lecture by Helen Noah, who will continue with arithmetic properties of local systems.
Okay, so thank you very much. So that's the last lecture. So there is no no picture on the board, and Ben can take a rest. Thank you very much. And I'm going to give a proof. The sketch of the proof. A sketch of the proof of the geometric theorem. And let me recall it. So we have X smooth connected quasi-projective over the field of complex numbers. And we fix here a good compactification. So we have divisors at infinity, normal crossing divisor at infinity. And we fix a delta, which is going to be the order of the determinant, natural number. And we fix for each, we fix an R here. That's going to be the rank of the local systems we consider. And we fix some roots of unity at infinity. So so J goes from 1 to R, and they are all roots of unity. Then we consider the Betti moduli space of X in rank R. So those are local system of rank R, complex local system of rank R, with the property that the determinant has finite order and order which divides delta, and with the property that the monodromies at infinity are quasi-unipotent of eigenvalues being those lambda ij. And in it, so that's the whole moduli space. Ben was explaining roughly how it goes. And in it, we take an open. And I'm just going to abbreviate by M. And those parameterize so we have here, inside of the complex fiber here, I forgot to say, so this is defined over a ring, a number ring. So this is a number ring, which can be explicitly given. So this number ring, this is just Z where we add the delta roots of unity and the roots of unity defined by the lambda ij. And so we can look at the complex fibers here. So when we look at the complex fibers, we have those complex points here, which correspond to local systems which are semi-simple without being simple, so they are not irreducible. And we can take the Zariski closure of this characteristic zero points. So the M here is MB with all the decoration minus the Zariski closure of the reducible ones. Over C. And now I write here, so now the theorem is, we consider M over spec OK, and we assume, so this structure morphism was denoted by epsilon, we assume that this is dominant. So dominant means precisely that there is a C point, so there is a local irreducible C local system. with those invariants, so rank R determinant of order dividing delta, and then quasi-unipotent monodromies at infinity with those eigenvalues here. So we assume that this is dominant, and then the conclusion I had written as a shorthand saying that epsilon is surjective. But in fact, the conclusion is stronger. So this conclusion is precisely the conclusion we are going to prove in case, so in case the complex fiber of the moduli is irreducible. But in fact, more is true, so this is equivalent, what we prove. But in fact, in general, the conclusion is stronger, and the conclusion is that for any QL bar point here, so for any L, and for any QL bar point here, L is a prime number. Then there is a QL bar point of M. That means there is, i.e., there is an étale absolutely geometrically irreducible L-adic local system. With this decoration, so determinant of finite order dividing delta and the lambda ij at infinity. Yes, thank you very much. So there is only x over c here. Should I write it again? I mean, there is only, yeah. But this is important to underline, so thank you very much. So that's a theorem, and just to remind you, this theorem implies the existence implies that the fundamental group, the topological fundamental group of this complex manifold consisting of the complex point of x here is weakly integral. I don't repeat what it means, but at any rate, it was giving a new obstruction. And I just repeat in words, a new obstruction for a finitely presented group to be the topological fundamental group of a smooth quasi-projective variety over C. Okay, so now how do we proceed? So we have this morphis here, and we start, so I give a set sketch here, and I will give the various points here, and in particular, what is the logic in the proof. And a posteriori, the logic is quite clear. But the question is where we start. So the first thing we start with is to say, you remember that M comes from this fundamental group which is finitely presented. Presented. So in particular, it is finitely generated. So as a corollary, M is a scheme of finite type. So algebraic geometry says that. Oh, I mean, the definition of this moduli. So now we have this structure morphis here, and M is a scheme of finite type. So whenever we have a morphis between a scheme of finite type and another one, spec OK here, then it is a case that the underlying reduced structure of this morphism is generically smooth. So, epsilon, let me write reduced here, from M reduced to spec OK, is generically smooth. Is there a question? I hear some. No, it's generically, yeah, thank you very much, on M. Thank you very much. Is that okay? So what does that mean? So in particular, I will find a close, this is what Mark says, I will find a close point on M with the property that the morphism in a Zariski neighborhood of this close point, and from it the reduced structure is smooth. Is that okay? So let us take Zo. There is a close point. Let me denote it by Z on M, such that epsilon in a neighborhood of Z. So we can even take the formal completion here of M at Z. And then from it, the reduced structure. So, it's smooth. Of course, the moment I take the, The moment I take the formal completion here, the image is in fact, so this point Z is a point in characteristic L. So the image here is going to land on the spectrum of the completion of OK at this place here. So let me say Z has characteristic L. So here, in fact, I'm going to land in spect OK at some completed at some valuation here of characteristic L, residual characteristic L in spect OK. So all that is pure algebraic geometry. Now we remember what the moduli parametrizes. So we have a smooth point here. So this Z here, so this is still algebraic geometry, but now from the viewpoint of the moduli, this Z here, which is a closed point, it corresponds to an irreducible representation of the topological fundamental group with values in GLR of a finite field of characteristic L. So let me say Z here. Corresponds to a representation here of this topological fundamental group with values in GLR of a finite field. And just to make it clear, let me write it like this. And this one, because it's smooth here, not only it's irreducible, but in fact it is even absolutely irreducible. That means as we best change from this finite field to its algebraic closure, it is irreducible. So let me write here, the term for this is absolutely irreducible. And maybe we give a name here, rho z. Okay? So far, this is algebraic geometry. Nothing more. There is no arithmetic, nothing. Okay, so we are still now in the world of algebraic geometry, but a little bit arithmetic geometry, because we stare at this morphism here, at this representation, and now this group is finite. So it has a finite order, because it's finite. So if I take P large enough, and in fact not so large, this P will never divide this order, okay? So in particular, it will not divide the monodromy group here, which is a subgroup of this one. But now, what does Grothendieck tell us? He tells us that when I take a finite quotient of this topological fundamental group, and I look, now I have to do a little bit of arithmetic geometry. So far we had only X over C, but now I think X is a finite type. So it's defined over a scheme of finite type over Z. And I can go to the mod P reduction of this scheme of finite type over Z for P large in the sense we just discussed. So let us do this. So we have here X over C, which is best changed from X over S, and S is a finite type over Z. Is that okay? And then x was not necessarily, so I just look at good reductions here. So x over s is still smooth. And in fact, if I had fixed this good compactification we had at the beginning, I can shrink s so that I still have a good compactification here over the model. And then Grothendieck is telling us that in this situation, if I look at a finite quotient here of this topological fundamental group, which is the same as the finite quotient of the Étale fundamental group, then this finite quotient which factors through the term fundamental group of X in characteristic P. So that means there is for any P large enough, and in fact we were saying what P's are allowed, all of them except finitely many of those, then we look at characteristic, so we look at S, which is a close point of X of characteristic P. And then there is a specialization homomorphism. So now it is over the algebraic closure. So here, this is, let's say, Q. The residue field of it's a close point, it's trace characteristic P, so let us say the residue field is FQ. So then we have a specialization homomorphism to FP bar. So if you like S bar, which is FP bar. And in fact, Grothendieck is telling us that if I go to the profinite completion here, it's going to be surjective. And it's going to be an isomorphism on all the quotients of order prime 2p. But I don't need this information here. I just need this information to say, that, well, let us write here. So these factors, of course, through the Étale fundamental group, so the profinite completion, because it's, and then this is an isomorphism on the pro p prime quotients. Okay, so in particular, it's going to be an isomorphism on this one here. What does that mean? That means the conclusion of this is that my representation, which was here, and which factors here, in fact, factors through here. Let me write rho bar here. And now FP bar. Is that okay? Now, so again, on this board here, as Mark was underlying, as Mark was observing, we have only X over C on this board because that's the moduli of topological local system. And it's defined over a number ring here. And I call this direction on the number ring L. But we have a hidden direction in this diagram here, so that's related to the fundamental group of X over C. But now, because of what I explained before, there is a hidden direction here, which is, makes it three-dimensional, which replaces X over C by X over FP bar, for many FP bar. So there is, so to speak, here a P direction, but which is not on the board. Just in our brain. Okay, so we are here. So this is still pure algebraic geometry, but a little bit more arithmetic because we involve here the specialization homomorphism of Grothendieck in SGA1. So maybe I should write here SGA1. Sure. No, it's a quasi-projective, and I forgot to write the term fundamental group, and I thank you very much for the correction. Thank you. It's okay. Okay. So we have here, so now we have a term representation here. And now you remember that this one was absolutely reducible, so this one is absolutely reducible because it's a factorization. So this is absolutely reducible. But now, in the last lecture, and maybe Ben has time to say a tiny little bit on it, or maybe not, maybe it's not really at the core of our discussion. Now that we have a characteristic P variety here, then on X FP bar here, we have this rho bar FP bar. And out of it, we can construct the deformation space of Mazur. And in fact, we can also decorate this deformation space by fixing again this decoration delta. So R, we have R here, where R is already contained in this information here, and lambda ij. And this is local formal over W of the W of FLM. And this is over this vid vector ring here in characteristic L, and the QL bar points of this deformation space, so that's Mazur's deformation space, the QL bar points here are L-adic local systems, which have the residual local system is precisely this rho bar. This rho bar being irreducible, then necessarily this one is going to be irreducible. This rho bar being absolutely irreducible, necessarily this one is going to be absolutely irreducible. And then it has this decoration, delta, lambda ij, etc. So that's the Q bar points. Now, because we took the Z here, you remember the Z was, did I make a picture here? So the Z was a close point here of this morphism here, and where the morphism is smooth here. So that means, because it's smooth, so that means there is a neighborhood, so not only we have an FL M point here, but we have also around the FL point, we have a ZL bar point here, because it's smooth. I mean, unless, because, and why is that? This is because we assume this is dominant, so the characteristic zero fiber is non-trivial, and consequently, when I go to a smooth point, then I have a germ above the base here. So we have this. So it is tempting to say we want, as a first information, we want this. And there is one more observation before I say that. Yeah, okay, let me finish my phrase here. We want a comparison between the formal completion of the moduli at the point Z with this deformation space. I just write deformation space here. So both are formal, both have as a residual point this residual representation which is here. But here, as Mark was asking, it comes from XC, in fact, the topological manifold here, while here it comes from X over FP bar. But now, again, algebraic geometry is going to tell us that, in fact, if you compare the functors, those two are the same. So in particular, under our assumption, then, so in particular, because of our assumption, this implies that this deformation space here and the characteristic zero fiber here, I say nonsense, this deformation space here over W FLM, this is also, I mean, at least if I take the reduced structure, it's also formally smooth. So this is a fantastic conclusion here. So there is a miracle here, but it's a miracle which has nothing to do with arithmetic here. It's really a miracle of comparing two deformation functors. So we are here. At the same time, you remember I had tried to write that on the board yesterday. We have the homotopy exact sequence, which is again due to Grothendieck. So we have one, the term fundamental group of X over FP bar. I apologize, I skip here the best points. And here the term fundamental group of X over FQ. And here we have the Galois group of FP bar over FQ. And here we have our rho bar, FP bar, with values in GLA of F, what do I want here, FLM. Now, when we have such a diagram here, there are two things which are obvious. The first one is, it's not obvious, but it's true, because I didn't really insist last time on the definition of the term quotient of the fundamental group. This is a question of Philippe. It is a case that this group here is topologically finitely generated. But this group is finite. So a representation of a topologically finitely generated group into a fixed finite group, there are only finitely many of those. So there are finitely many, such possible, let us write here, possible rho bar FP bar. There are only finitely many of those. But at the same time, so this that's a Galois group of a finite field, so we know that it is topologically generated only by one element, which is a Frobenius. And now this element here acts on those finitely many representations. Why? Because you lift gamma to somebody here, let's say gamma tilde, and then once you have a representation, you can take the conjugate representation here. And that gives you a new one. And, but that doesn't, in fact, depend on the lift here, because if you take another lift, then the twisted representation by the lift is going to be changed by your conjugation, and so the local system is the same. So we have finitely many such representations, finitely many such local systems. So if I replace gamma, so it's a permutation here of those. If I replace gamma by some finite power, let's say this one, then it's going to fix. So this fixes rho bar FP bar. Okay? What does that mean? That means that this is equivalent to saying, because this one was absolutely irreducible, so this implies that rho bar FP bar, possibly replacing FQ by a finite extension, I don't talk on that, it's going to, so because this representation is invariant here, if I replace FQ, so I replace, so this was an A here, so I replace FQ by FQ of A, but now this one is invariant here, so that means that in fact, the projective representation associated to this, that means rather than going to the general linear group, we go to the projective group, then this one is descends here, so we just have to lift the determinant, and possibly we do that after a finite extension, and okay, the Brouwer group here is trivial, so we don't need that, but this argument is a general argument, which is essentially due to Simpson. So at the end, by replacing Q by some power here, we can say that this representation here factors. And now I write FQ here, after replacing Q by some finite power. Okay, so, but our moduli functor, so where is our deformation space here? So because the rho bar now is invariant by Frobenius, and this is given by a functor here, so this is also acted on by the Frobenius. So that is what I had denoted by Yamar here. So the action is, so we have a rho bar from pi 1 x fp bar to glr of blah blah. So it assigns to C here rho bar fp bar of C. I haven't done anything. Pardon me? Yeah, so now the I had lifted the Frobenius here. So then the new representation rho bar, let's say upper gamma tilde lower fp bar, assigns to C rho bar of fp bar of gamma tilde C gamma tilde inverse. It's okay? So, okay, fine. Okay, so that means the Frobenius is acting here, because the residual representation here is Frobenius invariant. And now we make use of the fact of the corollary here of this algebraic geometrical fact that the formal completion of this measure space at this close point is the same as the formal completion of the Betti moduli space, I apologize, at this close point is the same as Mezer's deformation space. So, so we conclude that we are in the situation of de Jong. This space here, with all the decorations here, which is acted on by the Frobenius, has a property that the Frobenius invariant points here, and of it, the QL bar point is not empty. So that is de Jong's, this is implied by de Jong's conjecture. And I repeat, de Jong's conjecture has been proven by Gates-Gorry. Let me write it explicitly. Using the geometric Langlands program. And it has been proven if P is at least 3. But you remember our P was chosen randomly larger than the specific bound here. So this means here that there is, maybe at the cost, again, of replacing FQ by some finite extension of FQ, so there is now, we obtain a local system here, which is Eladic, on FQ, with the property that it is geometrically plus absolutely irreducible, and plus, so rank R, plus a decoration which I don't repeat here, delta and lambda ij. But now that's fantastic, because now I can apply what I tried to explain yesterday, which is purely de ligne. So let me write that. So we produced, again, starting from this purely topological data, we produced, by doing only algebraic geometry so far, arithmetic geometry, we produce an arithmetic local system of the mod P reduction of X, which is TEM, and which has all this decoration, which is absolutely reducible, blah, blah. So now we apply de Ligne's companion. Of course, de Ligne didn't prove the existence of the companions, but he had this fantastic formulation. So let me write de Ligne here. So I advise everybody to look at Vel 2 where he formulates the conjecture of the companion. Then for any sigma, so for any L prime, L prime could be also equal to L, but at any rate, it cannot be P. Then for any algebraic isomorphism, field isomorphism, from QL bar to QL prime bar, then there is a new arithmetic local system, let me write sigma here, which is a QL bar prime local system with the same condition. In fact, of course, Delin doesn't care about my story with, he does care. No, he does care. the order of the determinant and of the quasi-unipotent monodromy at infinity. But the way he formulates is that this one should have at all close points of the variety, so that means the finite fields of characteristic P, then characteristic polynomial of the Frobenius of the initial L transported by sigma as a polynomial with coefficients in QL bar should be the same. So that's, let's say for short, the L functions are the same with respect to sigma, for short. But I don't care about this very precise information here. I just, because the L functions are the same, this absolute irreducibility can be right off of that, and all the decoration can be also detected by this condition. So there is a local system here, which is again absolutely and geometrically irreducible. And then with the decoration delta and lambda g. But that's fantastic, because I'm nearly done. And why is that? Now let me write again what I have written on the somewhere, but I don't, here, but I make it cleaner. So we started with the topological fundamental group. And now we look at the specialization here to the tame fundamental group of X over FP bar for P large enough. And in fact, it factors here through the etal fundamental group. I just write the profinite completions here. Or maybe I just write like this, like in the lecture notes. That means the etal fundamental group. But then, by the homotopy exact sequence, which is still on the board here, then this one is here. It's a subgroup here, in fact, a closed subgroup of this one. And I forgot to insist here, so but I say in words, but I didn't write on the board, so this is also a local system on X over FQ. But now, so we started with this, we started just with this rho bar here. I don't write again. Just write the result here. So we have constructed, so using De Jong, we have constructed this LL here. And using the companions for any sigma, we have this LL sigma. I forgot to say LL, but it's QL prime. I mean, sigma could be also an algebraic automorphism of QL bar. And now I have all that here. So I can go back. I can think of this local system here. Look at its restriction on the geometric fiber. It's still irreducible. It's geometrically irreducible. I can post-compose with the, or pre-compose, I apologize, with a specialization homomorphism. So I obtain an etal local system here, which is L-adic or L-primadic. And I can think of it as being a topological local system. It doesn't matter. So that's it. That proves precisely the theorem, which is unfortunately no longer on the board. So we proved, let me repeat, If epsilon is dominant, i.e., there is an irreducible complex local system of rank R with a decoration delta and lambda ij, then we proved that for any, so then we construct a P. I just write in parentheses here. And remember that we took a P, but we had an infinite possibility for taking the P. But we took one, and then we proved that there is for any L, there is, a, I mean, for any, so we have a Q L bar local system for any, let's say like this, isomorphism between C and Q L bar. And for any L, which is not this P. Is that okay? So, I mean, the construction gives you, we managed to construct an arithmetic L-adic local system with all the decoration. And so that gives already one piece of the answer, because I think of this arithmetic local system on the mod P reduction as an L-adic local system on X over C via this sequence here of homomorphism. And but then I say, so I won for the theorem. I prove the theorem, but only for this one L. The last conclusion is, now I apply the companions. So this existence here was coming from De Jong. Now I apply the companions, and for any isomorphism from QL bar to QL bar itself, or QL prime bar, for L prime not being P, I find a new one. Yeah. Oh, okay, so that means another way to say that, I can identify QL bar with C, and then I say for any isomorphism from C to QL bar, I find an L-adic local system.
That does what? What's the condition?
I find an L-adic local system here, which is, so L, or prime for any, which is irreducible on XC, which is irreducible, and which has determinant of order dividing by delta, which has this decoration at infinity lambda ij, and which has rank R, which was precisely the theorem, except that I omit here the prime P. I was saying for any prime, I find one such, but here I omitted P. Okay, but you remember that this P here was chosen in such a way that it was bigger, it was larger than the cardinality of GLR of FLM. And this GLR of FLM was precisely the receiving group of the representation which corresponds to this closed point Z. So it's given. So the only condition on P is that I had good reduction for the scheme here for its compactification, and the P should be prime to, let's say, the order of GLR of LM. So I can take a P which is larger than this one and redo the same blabla. So let us do that. So now, final step. Remember that we can take now a new P, which is, let's say, a P1 or P2, which is more than the P we had, and redo the same blabla, redo the same proof. And now I will find new for any L which is not P2. So that will include P. Okay, that's the end of the proof here, and that's the end of the lecture. Thank you very much for your attention.